Take your family on a Lenten retreat at sea with Michael Voris and Father Z of the world-renowned Catholic blog, What Does the Prayer Really Say? Couples and singles should also cast off to the Caribbean for this 7-day trip, and those who have signed up are encouraged to introduce themselves ahead of time on our Facebook event page. Sign up for the cruise, please visit the website on your screen, or call 805-526-6565. That's 805-526-6565.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to The Vortex, where lies and falsehoods are trapped and exposed. I'm Michael Voris, but today, no lies or falsehoods. During this Christmas season, a close examination and meditation on our Blessed Lord is in order. Though he came to us in the form of a child, he was not destined to remain so. He did not arrive on earth to be a child. His divine nature came from the heavenly realms of eternity with his Father, but his human nature descended from his Jewish background. He had noble blood in his veins, which he inherited from the womb of the Virgin, who herself was from the lineage of the house of the great Jewish King David. This much is beyond dispute, for the masses would have never allowed the claim of his messiahship without this bare minimum requirement having been met. Our Blessed Lord would never deny his descent from the royal throne of David, but he went to great lengths to explain that his royal descent was not the explanation of the relation between him and his eternal Father. Matthew wrote his gospel to the Jews, presenting the parallel between their sacred writing of Genesis, where man was created, and this Genesis of the new man, the second man, one of a different order, not just one of many in the line of descent. This child is, in fact, a new beginning, a new Genesis. Matthew traces this child's roots back to the beginnings of the chosen people, setting him forth as both son of David and son of Abraham. Luke, writing for the Gentiles, reveals the child's descent all the way back to Adam. Luke desires that the Gentiles understand the humanity through the genealogy. Matthew desires that the Jews understand the messiahship through the genealogy. And then we have St. John. St. John, having taken into his house the mother of the new man, the mother of the Messiah, and having her profound, unmatched insight of being so full of grace and the mother of grace himself, John shows forth that this child is not only traceable to David, and before that Abraham, and even prior to that Adam, and moreover, not only that he was a new man, but that he came from the stars, beyond the stars, that he didn't participate in light, but that he is light. He is the source of the order, the wisdom by which all things were made, what the Greeks called the Logos, and what we call the Word. He is the source by which Adam, Abraham, and David came into being. Born of them all, he preceded each of them. So he is both beginning and end of the human race, the firstborn, not only of the Virgin who brought forth her firstborn, but first and only born of the Father before all ages. What child is this then? The Word, who was with God, who is God, who was in the beginning. A simple manger, cradling eternity, born in a town whose name means house of bread, who would grow to manhood to give us his flesh as bread to eat, so that we might live with him beyond the stars forever. From all of us here at churchmilitant.tv and St. Michael's Media, a very holy and happy Christmas from all of us to all and each of you. God love you. Merry Christmas. I'm Michael Voris.